We shall now take a look at algorithm, where I am going to show you how to find the sum of a series in which the terms are having a change of sign in the alternate position. That means initially it is 1, then it is minus 1 by 3, plus 1 by 5, minus 1 by 7, plus 1 by 9, all the way up till 1 by n. There is an interesting pattern in this series. Not only is the sign changing from plus to minus each time, also the denominator is increasing by 2 every time in this particular series. In order to find the sum of such a series, an easy way to do it is, if you see here, I am adding to the sum once and I am minusing from the sum. Then I am again adding to the sum, I am minusing from the sum. So this particular pattern is repeating in an alternate fashion. So in order to achieve the alternate addition and subtraction, I will use something called as a sign. Okay. Now what this sign does is, initially when sign is plus 1, I am going to take sum and I am going to say sum is sum plus 1 upon I into plus 1, because the value of sine is plus 1. Then, since it is becoming minus next time, I am going to multiply this sine with minus 1. Then what happens is, next time when I am trying to find the sum, it will be sum is sum plus 1 upon I into minus 1. So this way, it will add to the sum once, it will subtract from the sum once. So this alternate fashion of using this sign is known as the use of sign as a flag variable, because like the flag, it is fluttering between one direction to the other. So let us first try to understand what variables we will be using. One variable is, if you see, the denominator is changing constantly by 2. So I'll start the denominator variable by the name number with the initial value 1. End of the series by the variable n. Sum with the initial value 0. And sign 1, because the first time I need to add to sum. The only thing I need to get this series running and calculate the sum is, I need to get the value of n from the user. Once I get the value of n from the user, what I am going to do here is, I am going to do a repeat for count loop. So let us see what I am trying to do in this repeat for count loop. In this repeat for count loop, I am doing this particular block of finding the sum of this particular series, starting from count is 1, then count increases by 2, 5, 7, 9, like this, all the way till n. What it means is, suppose n is 7, that means it will execute it once, twice, three times and four times, because we are increasing the value of number by 2. So based on the value of n, that many times this particular count is going to run through. The first, what I am going to do is, I am going to say sum is sum plus 1 upon number. Okay, because number is the denominator here. Okay, so this number is in the denominator into sine. Sine is plus 1 initially. But what I need to do is, I need to make sine minus 1 next time. And also I need to increase number by 2, because from 1 by 1 it is becoming 1 by 3. So the next step is, I am increasing number by number plus 2. Sine is sine into minus 1. Why I am making sine minus 1? Because next time I am subtracting. So this particular loop will keep repeating till the value of count is equal to the value of n. And then finally, what I am going to do is, I am going to find the sum of this particular series at step number 4 and then stop. So what I will do now is, in order to get you to understand this particular sum of the series, as usual, we will end up taking a test table and running through the test. That's the easiest way and the only perfect way of trying to understand this particular problem. All right. So here is the series. Let's assume that the value of n is still 9. So in step number 2, I am going to say this denominator n is 9. So what is going to happen is repeat for count 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. That means this particular block is going to get executed 5 number of times. So at step number 1, number is 1, sum is 0, sign is 1. Alright. So what I am doing is the value of count, I am calling it as counter, it is 1. The first time I am getting in, it is 1. So if you see sum is 0, 1 upon number is also 1. 1 upon 1 is 1. Sign is also 1. You need to look, take a look at the previous values, because I am using the previous values first. So it is 0 plus 1 is 1. So sum at this point is 1. Then in the next two steps, what happens is sum is increased by 2. It becomes 3. Sign is multiplied by minus 1. So sign becomes minus 1. So next time you need to take a look at these values of number and sign respectively. So what is going to happen is when count becomes 3, okay, when count becomes 3, I'm coming here, then you will see that sum is 1, okay, the old value 1 plus 1 upon 3 is 0.33, but since I'm multiplying 0.33 with minus 1, it becomes minus 0.33. So it is 1 minus 0.33 is 0.67. After this, number is going to be equal to 3 plus 2. Number is going to be 5. Sign is going to be minus 1 into minus 1. It is going to be plus 1. It makes sense. Why it should be plus 1? Because next time the terminal term of the series is 1 upon 5. So let's come here. Now what you happen to see here is number is 5. Sign is 1. Now counter this time is 5. So this is the third time I am getting in. Sum is 0.67. which was the old value, plus 1 upon 5. 1 upon 5 is 0.2, but sign is also positive, so it should be 0.67 plus 0.2, it is 0.87. Number becomes 7, sign becomes minus 1. Okay, number becomes 7, sign becomes minus 1. It makes sense why it is minus 1 is because next time it is minus 1 upon 7. So what is going to happen now is counter is 7. Counter is 7 and 1 upon 7 is approximately 0.16, like that. That's why you are minusing from 0.87. So it becomes 0.73. Then again what happens is number becomes 9. This is minus 1 into 1. It becomes plus 1 because the next one would have been plus 1 by 9. Since it is plus 1 by 9 is approximately 0.11, 0.12, I am going to add to the sum. So once I add to the sum, 0.73 plus 0.11 is 0.84. Counter is 9, okay? And this was plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, it becomes minus 1. And the value of number has become 11. So the final value of sum is 0.84. Now when I write sum of series is sum, it will print this particular value 0.84 on your screen. So what I would request you, build a table similar to this. All of you must, for every algorithm, build a table and run through the logic. And this is the easiest and the most accurate way of verifying whether your logic is correct. Take for a bigger value of n. Take for a value of n as 13 or 15 and see whether you are getting this particular flow. Then you will easily understand the logic. The important thing in this algorithm is understand why I have used sign. I have used sign because I am adding, subtracting, adding, subtracting. That's why if you see, the value of sign is flipping like a flag in the alternate series. So please make an effort to understand this particular problem. Such problems are very frequently asked in your campus placement.